day?
A brand new 30-day adventure taking in a host of cities, sights and surprises.
Orally,
the sausage maker.
Are you sure this is just one toilet roll?
But if you're not popular, you could be voted off by your fellow passengers.
Say it quickly before you leave.
Bye-bye.
Watch out, Europe. This is Coach Trip.
Well, we had the ambulance this morning, then we've had the police, now we've had this row. I can't cope.
It's day two. The group are near Ypres in Belgium and there are seven couples on the coach. Amongst them are old friends Glenn and Wendy, who like to talk dirty.
I'm a domestic engineer. In other words, I'm a cleaner. I clean people's houses.
Just scrubber.
Best friends in the boardroom, Kevin and Steve.
Oh, I've been a higher grade than you.
Caring and sharing sisters, Emily and Annabelle.
We used to really hate each other when we were younger. Like, she used to always steal my stuff. She used to always tell off us all the time.
But like now I've grown up, you steal my stuff.
No, I don't fit in your stuff anymore.
And on hand, as ever, is Brendan, their international tour guide.
These tourists have got to remember, we leave on time and any hassle, they're red-carded and they're off.
At breakfast, friends James and Tom are upbeat, despite receiving the trip's first yellow card.
James and Tom.
Tom and James. Not ideal.
Today we're looking to sort of, you know, rise like a phoenix from the ashes. Yeah. Bring ourselves back up to our some glory.
But sat alone at breakfast, relations seem as cool as at last night's vote.
A little bit more respect was needed.
A little bit rude, mate.
You were rude, exactly.
Well, I think you're a little bit rude.
And lovebirds Mark and Kelly don't seem any more sympathetic towards the boys this morning.
They're on centre-hooks now, aren't they?
Yeah. Very different today.
Eggshells.
Staying out of the way a little bit today.
I just can't wait to get on the road again.
Well, very good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
It's an extra special day for Sandra, who's travelling with her son's girlfriend, Silvana.
It's our Sandra's birthday! Come on!
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday!
I got a call this morning from my son for my birthday.
Really?
Wishing me, yeah. He rang me 6 o'clock this morning.
Yeah, I didn't get a phone call.
It's not your birthday, it's mine.
Yeah,
no.
So this morning, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to Brussels! What do we know about the wonderful city of Brussels?
Just sprouts.
Yeah. Just sprouts.
I didn't know it was a place.
You just thought it was a sprout?
Yeah.
Annabelle and Emily, much as we absolutely adore them, they're probably not the sharpest tools in the shed.
It's the capital of Belgium.
I thought Belgium was the capital of France.
No, darling. Belgium's a different country.
Like, I had to think about it for a split second. Did she really just say that?
And it's the headquarters of NATO. Thank you, Kevin.
But smarty pants Kevin hasn't impressed Darren and his fiance James.
There was a particular person on the coach this morning who knew it all.
Brendan?
Yes.
So what was Louis XIV known as?
What was Robert... No, King Louis better known as? And well, no one cares.
Go on, tell us, Kevin, because you know...
He was the Sun King.
And then everyone went silent and he said, and still no one cares.
And there's also a famous statue and a fountain in Brussels, which is called the Mannequin Piss. And it's a statue of a little boy. It's a little boy, and he's weeing into a fountain.
Does it come out of his willy?
And it comes out of his willy.
The coach is heading to the Belgian capital, which is famous for its Grand Place, aforementioned statue of a boy weeing, as well as waffles and some very tasty chocolate.
So this morning we are going.
I'm scared.
Chocolate making!
And we've got Willy Wonka.
We have an expert on the coach.
Back home in Sunderland, Annabelle works in a chocolate shop.
Chocolate. Well, go on, tell us what you sell.
Milk, white and dark.
The chocolate shop Brendan has lined up has a few more flavours on offer.
Come with me and you'll be in a world of pure imagination.
Oh, really excited to go to the chocolate shop. I didn't think it was going to be like that, though, when we went in. I thought it was going to be like... a bit like Willy Wonka, actually. Like, yeah, lickable wallpaper and stuff.
No Oompa Loompas.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce you to Jess.
Hello, and welcome to the Chocolate Factory's bar.
So if you turn round, you've got a few little samples as well that you can... All these different flavours of chocolate.
This factory specialises in adding unique flavours to its chocolate, including spices.
Why is it hot?
Chili.
What's wrong with it? We don't want it, you eat it.
I bit half of it and I go and spit it out in the toilet. Pasta. That chilli one, it made your tongue feel like you'd had an allergic reaction and swelled up.
It had red spots in and everything.
Yeah, it was horrible.
So, I hope you liked all the good chocolates you tasted, because you're going to make your own chocolates right now.
Hats, guys.
First for the food hygiene. Can anyone make hair nets look good?
Awesome.
Clearly not.
Actually, it's a better look, actually, isn't it?
this is intriguing, to say the least.
Oh, intriguing. Oh, lovely.
Before you start your own creations, our chocolate master, Ayat, we'll show you a small demonstration about the technique of tempering the chocolate.
Tempering is done to control the rate at which hot chocolate cools to produce consistently small crystals, meaning it's much better quality.
Annabelle, have you done this at work?
I don't put on my lips.
The tourists will have the choice of three types of chocolate to create.
Everybody in the world likes chocolate.
Truffles, tablets, or Flemish speciality, the medallion.
Go over you go to your tables, thank you. No, I never eat chocolate, not when I'm on duty.
I've lost my ball! Sorry. Get a new ball.
I'm just going to help that boy over there. I think it's Steve. He just wants some advice about chocolate.
That looks like something the cat's popped in the cat litter box,
doesn't
it?
Oh, making really chocolate fun. Was really fun. The chocolate was hilarious. At first, I was like, no, don't put the chocolate on me, but it was a bit funny to get a bit chocolatey. I think Darren and James are the biggest chocolate-holics. He got told off the man.
I want to see discipline.
Oh, yes. Yes. They started it.
And Brendan seems intent on finishing it.
I think everybody was wearing more than the table.
Yeah. Brendan was going around kissing us, wasn't he? Which I thought was fantastic.
Yeah. Yeah. Very funny indeed.
I was covered in chocolate.
Yeah, all of us were.
I love it.
Never had his mouth empty then, did
I? I look all right. I might have just walked into a little bar of chocolate, but it was just an accident.
What is it?
Steve, what is it?
The mannequin piss, the boy in the fountain.
Please be very careful, this is going to be worth a lot of money.
Kevin is very competitive.
Yeah, but I think Steve's was better because his was more creative. He actually did a picture on his chocolate.
Yeah, but Steve
Kevin
wanted
just put
it.
Everything on there.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, you've all finished, so now it's time for the tasting.
To flavour their chocolate, they've been given various sweets and spices. Brendan's hoping his taste buds will be tantalised.
It's inspired by a cat litter box.
It tastes like cat litter as well. They're not very pretty either. They're all sort of thrown together, aren't they, really?
Annabelle, of chocolate.
Yeah, she said she makes it. She was the worst one.
We were bad, but she was rubbish.
She's the same as yours.
They're bedazzled without the dazzle.
They're nice. It's just nuts. It's just nuts. Right, James and Tom, which one did you make?
So these are our two here. There's absolutely no doubt in my mind that our chocolate making was far better than the rest.
No. What else did you put in?
A bit of the spicy stuff as well.
I can't taste that. Well, wait a minute.
Oh.
No.
but I felt that we needed to see something of Brussels. This depicts the mannequin piece. As you can see, it has a body, it has an arm.
Can I taste it? Can I just taste it?
Yes, you can do.
No, nothing.
This is art meets chocolate.
Sometimes he tells you a boring fact that you really don't need to know about.
This is fit for any gallery in the world.
Well, they're not boring at first, they just go into a bit too much detail, like we just need bullet point.
Tempt your taste buds.
Will it?
He's like a history teacher or something.
No, it's just, it just goes straight into this over the top.
Well, try it.
Is it good?
Oh yeah, a bit of a hit to this. And the winners of the chocolate making activity are Kevin and Steve.
We were very pleased to win the first competitive activity, but we are very aware that we're in a group where even winning could work against us.
I think ourselves in the group actually found it quite annoying that Kevin and Steve won.
Hey, what are you doing with that? Sorry, it's not yours. It's mine.
Perks of the job.
Thank you, Hyatt. You're such a thank you.
Coming up, Emily learned some basic life skills.
Yee-hoo! I love it!
I've never thought about breathing before. Like, you just breathe.
And the boys and Mark are at each other again at the vote.
Okay. Absolute nonsense.
Well, you constantly said that
it's not to be critical, that, is it?
Less fuel in for more miles out.
Most German car manufacturers test on some tough ground. Swedish ground. But only Volvo was born here. The Volvo V40 Cross Country. Available from just $299 a month.
Come on, boy.
Fetch. Go on, boy, fetch.
All right, I'll do it then. Lady Brassick's the brains behind the operation and trawled through all those comparison what's-its, you know, for car insurance, but came up trumps by going direct to Aviva. We call her Lady Geek Geek now, don't we, Hickson? You're not blessed with a sense of humour, are you, darling?
No.
Five-star car insurance from just £192 direct from Aviva. Little things matter.
When you make soup, you won't need any of these. Because the Cuisinart Soup Maker is all these things in one. It sautés, cooks, simmers, and blends. Then you serve. Oh, you will need one of those. The Cuisinart Soup Maker. Homemade soup made easy.
Slave. I don't want you to work all day, but I want you to be true, and I just wanna make love to you.
I'm pregnant.
Really?
About 2 weeks.
You already went to the doctor?
Not yet, but I took this clear blue test. It gives you two answers.
Oh my God, I think I'm gonna cry.
Clear Blue tells you both if you're pregnant and how many weeks. It's like two tests in one, only from Clear Blue. Double Serum from Clarins. An exclusive formula enriched with plant extracts in a two-phase system to target visible signs of skin aging. Skin looks more radiant, firmer, and pores look less visible. The UK's number one anti-aging serum, Clarins.
Dear Diary, I'm still fat, I'm still mad, but happy. I've got some great mates. a delicious boyfriend and not a care in the wait.
When does college start?
Is this Monday?
Oh, God. No, this isn't school, Ray. It won't be like before. This time, I'll be prepared.
Stay under the radar.
But most importantly...
Oh, no. It's John.
Do not have a meltdown.
Has anybody got anything they want to share this week?
My Mad Fat Diary starts tonight at 10 on E4.
Laterooms.com sponsors travel on 4.
It's the afternoon of day 2, and despite stuffing themselves with chocolate all morning, the tourists have still found room for another Belgian delicacy.
Show us how you do it.
Yeah, then what you do is you just grab this bad boy in there.
So, guys, how do you like the mussels? Has everybody tried them? Has everybody not tried them?
Mark tried them, Mark has. Have you packed
them out? I was sat near Mark at lunch, and I thought that he was particularly immature in reference to the national dish of this wonderful nation.
They stink and they look like snot.
Referring to it as snot, I thought that was...
I'm a huge fan of mussels as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, I'm a huge fan of mussels. I thought it was
dish.
Really uncouth as well. He just sort of sat back and was like, oh no, it looks like snot. Some people didn't like it, some people did.
And then just pop it in.
But at least they got in and had a go.
I've never had a mussel, so I can't.
You've never had a mussel?
No. Not to eat. Don't want a big piece.
Oh, like where you lick your tongue on.
It was lovely. I couldn't get enough. Couldn't get enough.
You're going to get mussels again?
Yeah, as long as they're pre-cooked. I don't want to chop carrots up, cut the carrots and open the mussels and shove a carrot in.
So the carrots come in the mussels? No.
What's that?
James's tone particularly can be quite condescending over lunchtime, where he's really condescending towards Wendy.
Tom and James do believe that they're intellectually superior to the rest of us.
With lunch over, the group are off to their second activity of the day, another deep sea speciality.
So, ladies and gentlemen, here we are. Yay! At Nemo 33. For your activity this afternoon, you are going scuba diving.
Nemo 33 gets its name from the depth of the pool inside. 33 metres, or 108 feet deep in old money.
So, ladies and gentlemen, this is the deepest swimming pool in the world. And this is where you're going to be doing your sub-aqua.
I thought we were going, like, diving.
You did?
I know, but, like, off big diving boards and stuff. That was what I said
similar.
Earlier. But, yeah, I was close. Quite close.
All for one. Go for all.
Get a mask. In you come, guys.
Nice.
I never thought this would happen.
I got him to hold my hands and I wrapped my feet round and I was playing with the flippers.
You've just had a fish sandwich.
It's not fish finger sandwich, it's a fish feet sandwich from now on. So when I see him, I'll say, did you enjoy your fish feet sandwich, my darling? Because his face was a picture. He went, ah!
The group are getting an introduction to breathing underwater using scuba tanks. In just half an hour, the expert instructors hope to take them down to a depth of 5 metres, if they can get their gear on.
You need, you know, sometimes.
And it's not just the tourists who are struggling.
Is it? All right, then. Bigger brat, too small.
Brendan's body looked amazing in his little shorts.
He's tanned, he's toned. Yeah. What a man.
With Brendan finally suited up, it's on with the lesson.
I've never thought about breathing before. Like, you just breathe. I must really... like rely on my nostrils because I felt a bit like I'm pleased I've got them.
How do you breathe out though?
You felt like you were doing this. Like a bit in labour. I've never been in labour, but what I imagine like labour's a bit like
proper, like panting.
Like heavy.
Like a gas mask.
Yeah, like a gas mask. Was that a gas mask?
Yeah, I'm breaking it a bit. I've only got a small mouth, so I couldn't get it all in. And I was gagging. I thought, I'm not going to do this.
Wendy was terrified.
Her pipe went, shh. And she went, oh.
Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better. Don't wear his weather. Take it from me.
I was actually looking at all the instructors, everybody else. I saw this whale go by at one point. Oh, no, it was Kevin.
I absolutely loved scuba diving today. It was on my bucket list, so yeah, I had a whale of a time.
Wow, you're doing great.
Thank you.
Getting your hair wet today, that was the highlight
for
me.
My hair is not even...
She does not like anything happening to that hair.
No, it's not even...
You don't touch that hair.
I had a really nice instructor, took me down, kept me calm, put a lot of faith in him, trust, and he just like made you breathe easy.
All right, Darren.
It's all quite romantic under there. You're not the jealous type, are you?
Not jealous type.
But you're glad I'll never see him again.
Think you've seen enough.
Absolutely amazing. And it's the first time I've ever done it. And the chocolate that I had in vast quantities earlier has helped with my buoyancy this afternoon. In more ways than one.
Yeah, I thought it was fantastic fun.
First time we've both done it as well, so it was nice to do something new.
Mark and Kelly look like they're enjoying themselves more than most.
Watching Kelly and Mark kiss underwater today,
I thought it was quite sweet that when they went under, they missed each other a little bit, head-butted. Went back and then went in for a kiss.
This must be underwater love.
The kiss today was a highlight underwater.
But I can't be sure that I kissed Mark.
Oh, no, you definitely kissed me.
There were six fellas under there.
Unless it was Brendan's tongue that went down my throat, it must have been yours.
It was a bit revolting.
Yeah.
No, it was really sweet. No, it was really sweet, actually.
By the end of the session, even a nervous Wendy has mastered it.
Yee-haw! I got it!
I never thought I'd be doing anything like I did today, Glenn. Scuba, no. Me, scuba diving. Yeah.
Clever girl.
I am, aren't I?
Fair play to her. She did it. She tried to give it a go. And that's what the activities, are on Coast Trip. They give you an opportunity to do something that you've never, ever done before. It's really amazing under the water. And now I'm going to go find Nima.
We'll see you later.
With everyone dried off and back on the coach, it's time for tonight's vote. Currently, James and Tom are the only pair on a yellow card. If they get another one tonight, they'll be going home after just 2 days.
We need to know who you're voting for and your reasons why. Thank you.
This evening, we are voting for James and Tom.
When we came to lunch, Wendy tried the moors for the first time, and then when we went to the garden, and Wendy was trying to get a recipe for the moors, you mocked her, in my opinion. I'm sorry, mate, but that was out of order.
I don't think I offended you at all, did I, Wendy?
No, darling.
I thought we found some common ground with Stephen and Kevin, and I thought that, and we were genuinely shocked by being voted by them.
Tonight, myself and James are voting for Kevin and Steve. They're just annoying. They have long-winded stories that just... And they just want to be there, at the front of everything. And...
I think in the long run, they're going to be too much hard work. There's nothing nasty in it.
That's all right. And that's all right. As long as it's just, I don't care. Thank you.
Tonight, we're voting for Emily and Annabelle.
Yeah, the reason is that today I tried to either strike up a conversation with you and you've killed it dead. It's the
I
same thing.
I actually didn't realise that at all.
Tonight we're voting for Kelly and Mark. Again, just don't feel like we've sort of bonded how we bonded with the rest of the group.
Can't get on with everybody. It's that's just, the thing, isn't it?
You're just not gelling as much.
We like you though.
We like it too.
We like it too. There's just no common ground.
Tonight we're voting for Silvana and Sandra.
We've decided to vote after much debation for Savannah and the mother. No, mother-in-law, Sandra.
We wanted to give Sandra a birthday present she'll never forget.
So
happy birthday, darling.
Sorry.
I told you I'll never forget your birthday.
I know, and I won't.
Tonight we're voting for Wendy and Glenn. I just don't think we've got as much in common.
If we weren't on the trip, they would be the last people I'd think, oh, like, if we're booking a holiday, shall we see if they want to come?
Thing is, Emily, nobody can get a word in with you. But we do enjoy your company.
Every couple has one vote each, except for Darren and James. Only James and Tom are yet to vote.
Tonight, James and I are voting for Mark and Kelly. At lunch today, he made a couple of comments about the muscles looking like snot, and I thought that was a little bit rude when other people were sort of trying it for the first time.
Nothing else whatsoever.
Nothing else.
Absolute nonsense.
For the food that they're eating to be regarded as snot and whatever, yeah, isn't nice.
So you took offence to that, that I did that in front of people and promptly went outside and sort the mickey out of other people.
Well, you constantly said that
it's
not
to be critical, that, is it?
Yeah, Mark's a bit strange. As we got to know him a little bit more today,
it's quite clear in our mind what's going on.
Don't really want to spend time with you anymore, if that's all right.
Ladies and gentlemen, the result of this evening's vote, with two votes against you, I award Mark and Kelly your first yellow card.
Thank you.
Thank you. And that's the end of this evening's vote. Thank you.
If they were looking for any reason in that whatever happened today, they were giving us the vote for the card that they assumed we got them. The gloves are off.
You said that last night.
Yeah, I did. No, I mean it.
Next time, the coach hits Luxembourg.
There's no one here other than us.
And sparks fly at the vote.
You stopped other people in the group from getting on with us or even attempting to.
I think you've said your bit for the second that we finish, I'm saying. Okay.
Just say it quickly before you leave.